Good evening. Thank you so much for coming out to the strategic planning. My name is Dr. Lawis. I'm the superintendent of schools. And who you're going to hear from over the next 10 to 15 minutes is our director of curriculum instruction, Jim Barbieri, our director of student services, Dan Gunderson, our business administrator, Lourdes, as well as our technology supervisor, Justin Masinkowski.
Hello, my name is Jim Barbieri, the Director of Curriculum and Instruction for the district. I'm here to talk to you a little bit about our student achievement over the past 3 to 5 years. Currently in the district, we have about 3,150 students, and that number has remained stable over the past 3 years, fluctuating between 3,113 and 3,180. Our student to staff ratio is approximately 11 to 1, and our administrator to staff ratio is 183 to 1. Every year, we are assessed by the Department of New Jersey under the Every Student Succeeds Act. They give us a variety of categories and delineate whether or not we have met the target for that category. In the area of English language arts and mathematics proficiency, we have met our targets, both for levels of proficiency and for growth. In the area of chronic absenteeism, we have not currently met our targets, but are working on some new programs to address that need. In the area of graduation rates, we have met our targets for 4-year graduation rates, but have not met our target for 5-year graduation rates. In the area of science proficiency, we are on par with state averages, and in fact, in the biology assessment, we are above state average in the percentage of students proficient, whereas only 42% of students statewide are proficient in biology, 49% of students in the Barnegat Township School District have demonstrated proficiency in biology. In the area of chronic absenteeism, the state target is 10.3%. Our district is slightly above that at 13.3%. We've put a number of programs and initiatives into place to bring the chronic absenteeism rate down to meet that state level target. Similarly, in the area of graduation rates, over the past 3 years, it has hovered in the high 80s and low 90s. So for instance, in 2017, we had approximately 88% of students graduate high school in 4 years. In 2016, that number was 92%. In the area of performance on the SATs, the Barnegat Township School District students have outperformed the state averages. For instance, on SAT reading and writing, 79% of students in the district have demonstrated readiness for college and career, as opposed to only 77% at the state level. In the area of mathematics, 65% of students in the Barnegat Township Schools have demonstrated performance that is deemed college and career ready on their SATs. This 65% performance level is above the state average of only 58%. We are pleased to report that over 70% of students who graduate Barnegat High School continue on to a 2 or 4 year college of their choice. Specifically, our average last year was 71.2%, which is analogous to the state average of 71.1%. As you know, every year the state administers the PARC assessments in 3rd through 11th grade for English language arts and mathematics. Over the past 3 years, we have seen tremendous gains in both math and ELA. For instance, the number of students meeting or exceeding expectations has increased by double digits in multiple ELA grades. For instance, the 4th grade went up 18.4%, the 5th grade 13.1%, the 6th grade 12.8%, and I'm pleased to report the 10th grade students, the number of students meeting or exceeding state proficiency increased by 19.5%. We're also seeing tremendous growth in mathematics. In the elementary schools, 9.2% increase in the number of 4th graders meeting or exceeding state standards, 6.1% increase in 5th grade, 5.3% increase in 4th grade. Those are significantly above state averages that only show less than 3% of growth, and we're having 5, 6, 8% growth per year or more. So we are very pleased with our growth in the area of math and ELA. I hope you've enjoyed this discussion of our Barnegat Township School District student achievement. As you can see, we have a lot to be proud of. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Dan Gunderson, Director of Student Services. I'm here to talk a little bit about our special education programs. Over the past few years, we've done a lot to improve our programs, and we've focused in the area of improving the least restrictive environment so that all of our students can be included with their typical peers. Over that time, we've created more ICR classes than we've had ever before. The ICR classes are now in all 4 of our elementary schools. Our self-contained classes have had more opportunities to be included in electives, and other classes with typical peers. Through this vision, we've been able to see many successes along the road that we're very proud of. Moving forward, we're looking to improve our programs and continue to be innovative and find new ways of being more inclusive and to provide even more opportunities for our students to be successful.
Hello, my name is Lourdes LaGuardia. I am the Barnegat Township School District Business Administrator. In my position, I am responsible for the finances and the buildings and operations of the 6 schools in our district. Currently, our budget operates on a $57 million budget. $200,000 of that budget revenues come from tuition, rentals, and advertising. Thousands and thousands of children graduate from the Barnegat School District. Generations of grandparents, parents, and children continue to re-enter our buildings. We are vested in maintaining facilities, educational services, and building maintenance. We have maintenance plans, gradual replenishment, and replacement plans to keep our school updated to the 21st century. Part of that includes our emerging technologies, our energy efficiencies, as well as our classroom renovations for flexible student groupings. Some of the challenges that we experience in the business office are rising costs, keeping up with aging facilities, our state and federal mandates, our 1% cap for budget growth of the local contribution, and our flat state aid. In addition to that, Barnegat School District is experiencing changing demographics. Over the last 7 years, the school district budget has increased the local levy by 1.88% annually. In addition to that, the local budget growth has been 2.33% annually. $30 million of our total budget goes directly towards student education and support services in the classroom. The additional expenditures are in administration, technology, transportation, equipment, and building facilities.
Hi, my name is Justin Marsikowski. I'm the technology coordinator for Barnegat Township School District. I've been here about 5.5 years, and I can remember when I first got here, about that time, on my very first day when I walked in, I was immediately walking through the library, and I was stopped by one of our librarians, who proceeded to rattle off all the issues with the district and what she needed. And from there, on my very first day, I realized just the amount of work that we needed to actually do around here. So with that in mind, one of the biggest things that we did is we brought a lot of organization to the actual district. So now, instead of people stopping us in the hallways and doing things like that, we actually have everything written down, everything's in email, everything's in our management system. So that was one of the big things that we instituted when I first got here. And also, one of the other things that we did when we first got here was, I remember when I looked at the internet, and the first thing I did was try to see how fast it was when I first got here. And I realized that my internet in my house was faster than the entire district. So that was one of the other big things we did. We upgraded all the infrastructure, especially because we had Park coming around the bend. It's going to be out the very next year. So we increased the internet quite a bit. We put together a bunch of wireless for the district. We did all kinds of things like that, and we've actually done that a second time since I first started here. And I just want to say that since I've been here, I've also tried to have it so that my department has been a lot more friendly and outgoing and open than apparently they used to be. So we're always trying to be approachable, and we always try to solve everybody's problems, you know, as good as we can. Because at the end of the day, it's not really about the technology as it is as much about the people. So I always try to put my relationship with the staff and the students first, you know, above all else. That way they know that, you know, we can actually fix their problems, and it establishes a good relationship with everybody. So that's been my number one priority, just to make a good relationship between technology and everybody else, because people are afraid of what they don't know, and a lot of people just don't understand quite how everything works. So we try to sit down with them and explain it. We make them very comfortable, you know, by the time we're done. So that was one of the big things. And moving forward, you know, in the future, we have a couple of exciting things that we're actually going to be doing. Eventually, we're going to be expanding the internet a little bit. We always look to do that, you know, and add devices and things like that. But I could see all kinds of different things coming down the pike for us to actually deal with. So in conclusion, I just want to say that it's been great being here for, you know, 5.5 years that I've been here. And I definitely look forward to another 5 years or more. But thank you very much.
Now that we've heard from some of the other district key leaders on our State of the District presentation, my portion right now is to touch upon some of the initiatives that we have going on for this school year that speak to some of the previous goals from the strategic planning, as well as some of the things that as the administrative team and as the staff we felt were very important going forward into this year. One of our overarching themes for this year was how we support our staff. The first thing that we put into place was a professional development academy. From a standpoint of staff feedback, this was something that we heard from a lot of our staff members. We have a great staff here. They're more than eager to take on new initiatives, take on direction for what they want in a classroom. They just ask, obviously, for the support and the training that goes along with that. So part of the Professional Development Academy, which is a multi-year plan, is to really provide that level of support in differentiating our instruction, the quality of the assessments that we do in the room, classroom management techniques, things of that nature. This initiative is led actually by their peers. So a lot of this was training that we did over the summer with our teacher leaders in the district that then take a cohort of teachers going forward at the 6 different buildings and then to provide that year-long support in those various areas following the year one curriculum. In addition, one of the thought processes was we looked at expanding our evaluation tool for this year. Previously, we would look at 6 different indicators out of the 17 possible indicators for our staff. This year, expanding out to the 17, which was really meant with coaching in mind, that we'd be able to provide that level of feedback on all the different aspects of a classroom lesson to our teachers. The PD Academy really then supports what we're going to be looking for those 17 different indicators. And finally, we made the move to Genesis evaluation tool, which really then streamlines the process and really provides an online database for us to not only store the evaluations, but also communicate a little bit more seamlessly with our staff and hopefully give that feedback in a much more timely fashion than maybe we have in the past. The second overarching group of initiatives I'm going to speak about talks about really how we're supporting our student body. So first, for our high achievers at the elementary level, we're revamping the Gifted and Talented program. We took a tremendous step this year in expanding out the program to not only be just a quarter per building, but to really now be a year-long initiative. In addition, we've revamped the curriculum now so it covers all the different academic areas, as well as the format in which the curriculum is going to be delivered, really emphasizing project-based learning and inquiry-based learning. For our struggling learners, we've expanded upon our response to intervention process, which is known as our RTI process, and really this covers 3 different umbrellas: literacy, mathematics, and behavior. So any of our students that are really struggling in any one of those 3 areas, we have a multi-tiered level of supports that are going to be rolled out that start with teacher interventions in the classroom, expand to online platforms such as Nessie, which will support our struggling readers at the elementary level, to then escalating to an actual RTI interventionist that'll provide a pullout program working with those students. A key thing of the RTI process is that it's a transition to root cause analysis. So instead of just providing support for what's going on in the classroom, it now expands out based on a root cause analysis, which is identifying really what is the root cause for that student struggle and then really developing a plan that attacks that root cause. In addition, we are very fortunate and very happy to report out that we were recently notified that we are a recipient of the pre-K grant. You might have heard me talk about this through School Messenger, some updates to our website, but really what that's going to provide us is $4.3 million to run and operate 24 different pre-K classrooms for 3- and 4-year-olds of our extended Barnegat family. So this is a really exciting opportunity, and for us, this really allows us to provide a research-based curriculum with certified teachers to support our 3- and 4-year-olds as they start their educational journey a little bit earlier than what they traditionally would in kindergarten. Finally, we've rolled out an Upstander initiative for this year, and that really speaks to all 6 buildings. We're going to honor an Upstander each month from the different buildings, and really what it means to be an Upstander is somebody that looks out for their fellow man, somebody that really does something positive to improve the culture of their building, but really it's the opposite of a bystander. So this is a direct link to our HIB policy and speaks to really the type of caliber of character that we want in our student body and really trying to emphasize and really highlight that and promote that within our different buildings. In addition to support our student bodies, we looked at expanding some of the opportunities. In the middle school and high school, you'll see that we've added Cyber Patriot as a club, as well as a Bulldog and a Bengal Buzz, respectively, in the middle school and the high school club for our student body to step out and provide more experiences that are outside of the classroom. Finally, I'm going to speak about an initiative that we have that really speaks to the community partnerships. This year we've partnered with Barnabas Health to do Communities That Care. As a district, that shows us expanding our walls to include key leaders in the community, your township council, the police force, as well as different faith-based organizations, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, etc. So really bringing all those key leaders together to really identify as a district and as a township where our biggest needs are, and then in turn putting in supports to address those biggest needs, whether they happen within the school walls or outside of the school walls. With that being said, thank you so much for attending and participating in the strategic planning. Really, for us to have success as a district, we need to partner with you, the parent, the community leader, the community stakeholder. And really, you know, it takes a village to raise a child. We truly believe that here in the school district, and we couldn't be more thrilled that you took time out of your busy schedule to come out and participate in this. It's really, really important. And by you being here, you're demonstrating that you feel it's important as well. So thank you so much. Together, we can expand upon the great district that we have now to make it even better. So thank you so much.